His journey from Berlin to America. And of course, we had to include the ballad, The Moritat of Mackie Messer, but just to make it a little bit funky, we did it the Yiddish version. That was the Yiddish version, in case you were trying to understand the German. That was the Yiddish version, translated by Michael Wex for a production that was put on by the Dora Wasserman Yiddish Theater. So let's stick around in Germany for a minute. This next piece, these next few pieces come from really his most famous work, the Three Penny Opera, which he wrote with Bertolt Brecht. But they eventually agreed, I don't know why, and they wrote Happy End, which is the biggest financial and artistic and critical failure of Weill's career, so he probably should have followed his heart. But in that show, like in all of his quote-unquote failures, there are just endless, incredible works that for the ages, as they say. And this next song is really one of his most well-known songs, and it's called Surabaya Johnny.
Thank you.
I hope you'll forgive us for not being totally chronological in this program. We're going to jump ahead 10 years. Actually, he's not in Berlin anymore. He's in America already. But he's written a song that is very much in his German style. And the lyrics are by his great collaborator Bertolt Brecht. Actually, it was a show that Brecht had presented in 1936 with a score from Hans Eisler. But Weill found the lyric, wanted to set it himself. So he presented his wife, Lotte Lenya, with a Christmas gift in 1939 of this song, Nana's Lied, which was actually never published in his lifetime. And actually, she never performed it publicly. Actually, she did perform it once for Brecht when he was visiting in 1940. Apparently, it was an unforgettable performance. I'm just going to read you the English translation of Nana's Lied. Meine Herren, gentlemen, I was only 17 when I landed on the love market, and I learned a lot of things, mostly bad, but that was the game. Still, I resented much of it. After all, I am a human being. Thank God it all goes by so quickly, both the love and the sorrow. Where are the tears of last night? Where are the snows of years gone by? As the years go by, it gets easier on the love market, easier to embrace a whole troop. But it's amazing how your feelings cool off when you're stingy with them. After all, everything gets used up eventually. Thank God it all goes by so quickly, both the love and the sorrow. And although you learn the tricks of the trade on the love market, it's never easy to convert lust into small change. Still, it can be done, but meanwhile, you get a little older. After all, you can't stay 17 forever. Thank God it all goes by so quickly, both the love and the sorrow. Where are the tears of last night? Where are the snows of years gone by? Aber man ist auch mit ihm. 22nd of March, 1933, Kurt Weill arrived in Paris with a small suitcase, and he tried to make a go of it in France. And while he was there, he wrote a lot of great music, including an amazing work called Marie Galante that our friend here, Aleks, is slightly obsessed with. Where he became obsessed with it. And there isn't much by way of recorded versions of it, so Aleks did a ton of work trying to recreate arrangements of this seminal viol masterpiece, which we will now enjoy three or four pieces of instrumentally, and then I'll sing a piece from Marie Galante, which didn't have lyrics originally, but eventually Roger Vernet, I think, wrote lyrics to Yukali, so I'll see you in a minute. Enjoy.
Thank you.
presque au bout de monde. Oh,
susceptible to everything.
There we go.
Every possible thing that there could be. You generate electromagnetic energy.
Thank you.
Generate electromagnetic energy. Everybody in this room does. Sometimes.
Too much.
It's a little. Yeah. We'll see if that works.
Ladies and gentlemen, Aleks Schürmer on the. You ever tried to write a Broadway musical? It's serious. It's a serious pain in the ass is what it is. So he was brought over by Max Reinhardt, the great theater impresario, to put on a huge, crazy show. A crazy show called The Eternal Road, with a libretto by Werfel and a book by Werfel. And he came and he worked on that, and it was kind of a debacle, and it was way overblown, and it was insane. It was not a great success. And the first show he wrote was something we'll come back to later on, which is called Johnny Johnson. That was his first show in 1941. That was about 1940. But in 1941, he had a hit, finally. He also wrote Knickerbocker Holiday right before his hit, which was Lady in the Dark. That was a big hit. Knickerbocker Holiday wasn't such a big hit, but he wrote September Song for that show, which you may or may not have heard. It's one of his, that was his biggest sort of single. He had a big hot single in 1940, and then in 1941, Lady in the Dark. This next song comes from that show, and it really put Danny Kaye on the map for singing this ode to Russian composers. And it's actually the first show and the first lyrics that Ira Gershwin wrote after the death of his brother, George. This is Tchaikovsky and Other Russians. Street Scene, which was really a very sophisticated merging of theater and music, and was incredibly influential in the history of Broadway. It was sort of the first of its kind, a really serious situation on the Broadway stage. And now more opera companies perform it than sort of Broadway productions of it. But at the time, this song is called Lonely House, with lyrics by Langston Hughes. And actually, it's just noteworthy. Please do check out, scan your little code thing for more information about all this music, because the lyricists that he worked with were always just incredibly the best writers in the business. When he was in Germany writing with the greatest writers, and then when he got to America, Langston Hughes, Ira Gershwin, Ogden Nash. So this is called Lonely House from Street Scene.
Thank you.
Producing hip-hop bangers. And I collect old vinyl. And I found a record of Lost in the Stars. And that's really what set me off on this sort of journey of being utterly obsessed with Kurt Weill. If you ever find it, please check it out, Lost in the Stars, an unbelievable show based on Cry the Beloved Country, set in South Africa. Every song is just a masterpiece. The song Lost in the Stars became very well known. And because we are doing such a, just the scratching of the surface of this vast repertoire that Kurt Weill managed to create in his very short life, we're going to sing a song that actually didn't make it into the show. And it was sort of on the cutting room floor. But if you listen to the show, and you know this song, you hear little bits of it throughout the show. He kind of used it as a theme, but it didn't make it as a song. He was very good at taking older things and reusing them in new works. So this is kind of a trifle. It's called The Little Tin God, which is a clock. And again, working with one of the greatest writers of his generation, a fellow by the name of Maxwell Anderson, who nobody has ever heard of now. Has anybody ever heard of Maxwell Anderson? Isn't that sad? But at the time, he was the man. He had a million shows on Broadway. He had hit novels. The Little Tin God. We come like the rainbow, and we go like the shower. And there's no use living if you don't like yourself. Words to live by, Pemi. Amen. Ruch Hashem. Okay. Thank you so much for coming. Oh, no. feel like we can sing and play so much more Kurt Weill. Maybe in a couple years you can squeeze out another program. But really, it's been my honor to be a part of your 19-year legacy. Congratulations, 19 years. And so, I mean, you're doing such important work, playing interesting repertoire. If anybody feels like chipping in and supporting Autour de la Flûte, please give us your money. I mean, maybe give it to her. Don't give it to me. But really, thank you so much. I mean, Aleks Schürmer here. tons of work to create these arrangements, and it's been my great honor and privilege to work with all of you, and some of you are old friends, and some of you are new friends, and it's been a lovely experience. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you get a bit curious about Kurt Weill. There's obviously this kind of snobbishness about Kurt Weill, and the German Kurt Weill is really the serious Kurt Weill, Mahogany, the Happy End, and the Three Penny Opera, his serious music. Check out his Broadway shows. They're unbelievable. Lost in the Stars, Johnny Johnson, Knickerbocker Holiday, whatever. Lady in the Dark. Don't forget Lady in the Dark. So one more song from his first Broadway show, which was Johnny Johnson. A song, there's a great version of this. No, never mind. Okay. But Burgess Meredith sang this. And it's sort of hinted at throughout the show, but it's only sung for real at the very end of the show. It's a crazy story about this sort of idealist, this anti-war idealist. It was put on by the Playwright Association, the sort of communist playwright group that he joined right away and wrote this with Paul Green. It's a long story. You'll check out Johnny Johnson, but eventually he's put into a mental institution and eventually after 10 years he's released and he is on the street selling toys. He won't sell soldier toys to little boys, and he gets in trouble for that. But he's just sort of left on the street selling these toys. It's called Johnny's Song, but it's also called Listen to My Song, and it's also called
To Love You and to Lose You.
To Love You and to Lose You.
And maybe something else.
I think it kept adding different titles to try to make it a hit, and it kind of never worked. So thanks again for coming. See you next time. This is Johnny's Song. Yeah. Yeah, I guess we'll do that.
Yeah.
We might as well. Ready? Who said no?
Now we might need some help.
Maryse Legault on the clarinet. Brandyn Lewis. Stefan Schneider. This guy, you already met everybody else. Okay. Let's have a, maybe we should have like a audience for presentation.
Yeah, I feel like there's something missing from this.
Maybe we can have a book. Saturday night, getting wild.